already. Yes. So for my small talks, I decided to do a talk on careers in EM. So let's get into it. So most of us, when we go into emergency medicine, you're usually here, there's only like two paths, right? Either you do community work or academics, and you're basically just working in the ER for both. So coming in, that's kind of the idea I had in the end. But it turns out there's a lot of different fields or paths that we can go into. There's a lot, so I'm not going to go over all of them. I will give you some references at the end where you guys can look it up on your own. So I'm only going to talk about a few, okay? The way I'm going to do this is I'm going to name some alums, okay, as examples, and that'll be what we're talking about. So our first alum does a lot of things. He is involved in concierge medicine. If you guys don't know what concierge medicine, it's this service that's offered usually to people that have more money than you and I. And they pretty much have their own private doctor on call. They have their cell phone, etc. And this alum has a company called Dr. 911. So it's interesting the stuff they offer. So just to read a little bit. So 24/7, adult or pediatric, they can either go to companies or a hotel room. I don't know why they would go to your hotel room, but apparently they do. Or your house. And amongst the things they offer are nebulized treatments, and they offer pregnancy tests, drug screens, D-dimers, and rapid stress tests. So that's pretty interesting. He was also a sideline physician for New York Jets for a while. Is a consultant for NBC and worked at the Rio Olympics. Writes for Forbes for medical section for Medscape as well. And he's an attending at Lenox Hill. This gentleman is Dr. Glatter, is his name. Okay. Our second alum is an alum of our residency program. He went on to do a toxicology fellowship at NYU. Worked at Long Island for a while. I'm forgetting exactly which hospital he did. And a few years back was actually named the director of toxicology for New York City Poison Control Center. This is a huge deal. I mean, they get, let me look it up, 70,000 calls a year. That's insane. Like, just consider how many calls you get a day. It's one of the bigger toxicology programs in the country. They offer services for over 150 languages. So this is one of our alums, oversees the whole program. I think this is pretty awesome. This is Dr. Sue, okay? So another one you guys might have already heard of because she often comes to talk to us. It's an example of two things that you can do in EM. One is telemedicine. If you guys aren't familiar with telemedicine, it's the concept where the practitioner isn't there face-to-face with the patient. Instead, he or she uses technology to communicate. So this is an up-and-coming field, not just in EM, but in other fields. She marries this along with palliative care. So in her services called Call 9, what she does is for nursing homes, she tries to kind of, how do I say this, save the unnecessary visit to the ED by having her services offered. They'll have workers go there, and usually the EM physicians in the other line assessing the patient, and they direct that the worker that's on site to give either NEBs or whatever treatments available to try to stave off that EM visit. Worst case scenario, it doesn't work, or they deem that the patient needs to come to ED, the patient comes to the ED. So this is Dr. Rios, okay, Carissa Rios. She was working at Highland a couple years ago, and I think she's back in New York concentrating on the Call 9. You guys already met this fellow alum, but I'll briefly mention her again. She was here for our wellness day. Dr. Lau is an alum. As you guys know, she's really big on meditation, as you know, for I guess for health purposes and just to treat stress. She focuses on private parties and corporations, and she has a strong interest in meditation for people in the health field specifically. She briefly mentioned this at the end, and I'll reiterate this for you guys. So every year she goes to the Himalayas, to the Tibetan Plateau to offer health services as well. If you guys didn't get that name when she came here, it was called the Nomads Clinic, okay? So I think she's a good example of pretty much international EM and also another totally different career path, which is the meditation. Alright, so this guy, he doesn't need an introduction to most of us. Maybe the interns aren't familiar with him, but he was our former ED director here at UHB, one of our alums. If you guys didn't know what he did before he was at UHB, he was actually the director of Sutter Health System back in Sacramento, California. If you guys aren't from California, I went to med school at UC Davis. Sutter Health System is huge in Sacramento. It's like the biggest health system in Sacramento. Came back, was our medical director. Fortunately, he went to NYU recently. You know, we'll all miss him. So he is now the vice chair of clinical operations for the entire EM program at NYU. This means he's in charge of up to 7 EDs. This includes their main campus in Manhattan. It includes Lutheran, which most of us rotated through already. If you guys are interns, I believe you guys start rotating their second year now, correct? Do I have that right? Yes, okay. So this is Dr. Foley. We're all familiar with him, I think. So he's a perfect example of admin. So there's another field you guys can do, administration. Most of us know this guy, maybe a few of the interns in second years might not know the following decision. He's one of our grads. He went on to do ultrasound fellowship at Brigham and Harvard. He's still doing it because he's in a 2-year program where he gets a master's at the end. And he also does a lot of cool international medicine things. The past few months, he went to Haiti to teach ultrasound in Haiti. This is something he's been doing since he was a resident here. And he also had probably the most awesome trip I've ever seen on Instagram, which is where I posted pictures with his permission. So he ended up going to Asia and Europe mostly. So he went to India, to Korea, Japan, Thailand. Then he went on to Florence and Tuscany and Paris. And this whole time, he was basically being wined and dined in like Michelin star restaurants on the company's budget. So like, he's just a lucky bastard. This is like the most awesome in the world. If you guys, so I looked up, so I messaged him. The company, if you guys know, you're interested in working for this company, which I was, which is why I looked it up. DCS Travel is the name of the company that he was working for, okay? So this is Dr. Breville. Like I said, I took this from his Instagram. He told me I could use it as long as I gave him credit for the Breville Wears Nada, which is his Instagram handle. Okay. So like I said, a good example of both ultrasound and travel medicine, I thought. Not an alum technically, but still pretty cool. And he's also my advisor, so I kind of have to give a shout out to Dr. Gore. He's, I think, a perfect example of someone that does advocacy and community work. You guys are all familiar with CAVI, the Violence Prevention Group. And he also is involved in the TED programs. I'm sure you guys listen to TED Talks. He actually has a TED Talk if you haven't listened to it. I can give you guys the link at the end. Pretty awesome guy. If you haven't met him, then meet him. All right, so kind of a mystery alum. That's such a real mystery to you guys. You know, been around here for a while. But was an alum of NYU for residency, but then became our alum when she did an ultrasound fellowship. She had her master's in education at UPenn, is involved in the Fem and EM blog. You guys know who I'm talking about?
T. Smith.
Exactly. So Dr. T. Smith. So these are the great resources that I was mentioning. So I don't know if you guys got the Emory Fellowship guide over the mail or not. Do you guys know what I'm talking about or no? So it lists all sorts of fellowships that I didn't even know existed. So it has your usual stuff that we know about, your like wilderness, ultrasound, SIMS, education, etc. But it also offers cool stuff like hyperbarics. There's some fellowships in women's health. There's aerospace medicine, which I didn't know was a thing. There's also things like tactical medicine, in case you want to work with either like the army or the police department. So other cool stuff. I can't name them all, but look up that guy. That's the link. Just in case Emra didn't mail it to you, you can always just look it up online. It's often for free. Also, Medscape had an article called "I've Had It with Medicine: 16 Options for Second Careers." It talks about all sorts of things, like opening up flower shops and all these like, stuff that like EM, and not just EM physicians, but other physicians do. Amongst the ones that come to mind that I never thought about, apparently there's some physicians that specialize just in doing CME lectures. So they just prepare CME for everyone, they educate physicians. There's also physicians that work for venture capitalist firms. So they will advise companies like, this is a good investment, this is a bad investment, and they pretty much work in the market, make a lot of money. So that's another option. So a lot of cool stuff, read that article. So special thanks to Drs. Carmel, Vicente, Silverberg, and Dr. Terry Todd. And that's pretty much it.